here, big dog. All right. Well, this is the beginning of day 7. One of the subscribers, Matt Liberani, here invited us to breakfast. I forgot, didn't even realize he lived here. I sent him something a while back. He got his ear. He hit me up yesterday and said, hey, let's have breakfast. So, always good to eat. So,
yeah.
We're going to head out today and go out across Highway 50, loneliest road in America, and hopefully end up in Sacramento tonight. So, we're off and running. So, we will see what happens next. See you from the road. Right here on the right, on the corner, is the Economy Drug and Old Fashioned Soda Fountain, where I had such a great root beer float the day before. On the left is the Hotel Nevada, where I had a so-so breakfast at the Denny's the day before, because it was the only place that I could find to just have breakfast. And so now, let's head on out of Ely on Highway 50. Headed out to the Kennecott Mine. Coming up on the right here, you can see where they've created a tunnel-type bridge to go under Highway 50. One time it was just a regular-looking bridge. Now they've done it this way. Thank you. the sheriff passed us about 10 or 12 miles west of Eureka, drove up the road about 3 miles and was hiding behind rocks up there trying to catch us speeding, which we weren't, especially on this freshly oiled road. In some of these curves and in some of the straight spots on this road from here to the city, the town, you will see some red on the road, and that is from what's left of the Mormon crickets migrating across these roads. Thank you. that was the last formation of any kind for about 40 miles. Beyond here, the temperature shot up into triple digits, and we began to encounter more winds of up to 60 mile an hour gusts, mostly headwinds, but quite a bit of crosswind. It was very miserable. How about some footage from Donner's Summit? We went from about 100 degrees at Fallon to 58 degrees up here on Donner. Jennifer already had her jacket and stuff on because she didn't feel good, but I was getting cold, so I had to pull over and get a jacket and change a battery in the GoPro. Well, I didn't shoot an end piece that day. I just forgot and think of it. Took a couple of still photographs, but it was a really long day. We were tired. It had been very windy most of the way across Nevada. A lot of it was into a headwind, though. Probably about half of it was into a headwind, so that helped. But it was hot from just west of Austin all the way into Reno. It was hovering around 100 degrees. And we stopped in Fallon, got some iced tea and rested a minute, got some gas. So it was a long ride. It was about a little over 5 hours, including our little break in Fallon, to get from Ely to Reno. And then it's only a couple of hours from Reno to Sacramento over Donner. So that's why you saw a lot more desert footage, because we spent a lot more time out there. And Donner Pass, while it is beautiful, does tend to look the same. One curve looks much like the next, and so I didn't want to bore you with all that. So, anyway, for a video that was 100% Harley rides, I know that you train lovers probably aren't going to watch this, but you Harley people are. Anybody who does watch it, I hope you appreciated the footage, but we did nothing that day other than eat, get gas, and ride. So, all right. See you tomorrow.